Hey everyone, just got in from work. I wanted to catch up with y'all right quick. Hope everybody had a good day. I titled this, well, I didn't really title it, but I did my normal hashtag Waldo Warriors and then I added a hashtag baby steps. And that's what I feel like I'm taking right now is baby steps to try to get back to somewhat of a normal life. And today after work, I ran to the dollar store right quick because they've got a new one now in Wynn that's right on my way home. And I needed a couple of things, and Dallas needed a couple of things. And can't come home without anything for Dallas, you know. So I ran in there right quick and I was looking around, and because it's a fairly new store, and I've been in there a couple of times, but I still wanted to just kind of look around. And I got to seeing things that I would normally buy Robert, you know, like a Coke Zero or just different things, snacks that he liked. And it's, you know, such a habit because, you know, we were together for so long that you automatically start reaching for those things, you know. And then I caught myself and I realized, you know, I realized. And so I didn't have a meltdown in the store. So I'm thankful for that because I've been kind of not really afraid, but kind of concerned that that might happen at one point. And I'm not saying it won't. But I didn't. And I thought to myself after I did that, I thought, this is the first time I've been in a store since he died. And now that one, that point right there kind of almost made me emotional just thinking about that. But you know, I didn't let it get to me. And I and it's good to know that, you know, and I keep saying this, but it's so true that even in the midst of this sorrow and this grieving that I'm walking through right now, I can still rejoice in the Lord and be thankful to God for the strength that He gives me each day, because every day I need new strength for something else. And He's always there right behind me, right beside me, giving me the strength that I need for that moment or for that day. And that's why it's so important not to look to tomorrow. Not to worry about what might happen tomorrow or anything like that. And I'm not saying we shouldn't plan and make plans and things like that and be responsible, but I'm saying as far as like trying to borrow trouble, as they say, from tomorrow or next week or next month, we don't need to do that because God gives us the strength for that day and sometimes for that moment of that day. And sometimes it's enough just getting through that day. So why would I want to worry about tomorrow and the next day and the next? And I still know I'm going to have those moments when I fall apart, and I still know I'm going to struggle at times, but I can be glad and know that God is with me there as well and keeping His hand upon me and leading me and guiding me to whatever point He wants me to be at. And I still don't like it. And I'm going to keep saying that because I don't like it. I would much rather have Robert here with me because I miss him so much. But I mean, I can still see the bigger picture. And it's hard to do sometimes. And earlier today, I got to looking at some. I don't know why it interrupted my signal. But earlier today, I got to looking at some of his pictures on my phone. And there was a couple of them that I really liked, you know. And I just kind of got to looking through them and stuff. And it just. I almost lost it at that point. Like, I thought I almost lost it in the store, but I really almost lost it earlier today when I was looking at the pictures because it just makes me miss him so much more, you know, to see that face and that big old smile. And you know, to know that I can't hear that voice anymore, and I can't feel his hugs anymore. Cause, like I said before, he gave me the best hugs. And if I had a bad day, or anything like that, then I knew as soon as I got home, you know, when or he got home, whichever the case may be, all I had to say was I need a hug because I had a bad day, and he would just wrap me up in his arms and hold me, you know. And that's something that I'll never feel again, you know. And so times like that, yeah, I struggle and yeah, I'm sad. But at the same time, I can be happy that I did know him and I had the privilege of knowing him for the amount of years that I did. And that God, you know, I can be thankful that God put us together. And even though I'm sad and I'm hurting and I wish he was here, I can still know that God is faithful and God is just and God is fair and he has a plan and a purpose for me. And so I just wanted to let y'all know that. You know, a couple of times I've struggled today, but I, the matter of fact, this is the first time I've cried all day. I waited till I got home, I guess. And I was talking to my friends here on the phone on Facebook Live. You know, but I didn't fall apart, I didn't cry. And so I'm just so glad that God gives me the grace and the strength I need for that moment in that moment. And I'm thankful that, like I said, I don't have to worry about tomorrow or next week or next year or whatever because God will be there with me then as well. So just be encouraged tonight and know that, or today, it's not tonight yet, You know, that if you're serving the Lord, you're going to go through trials and troubles, and you're going to go through things you don't understand, and you might suffer loss. It might not be a loved one, but it might be something else. But just don't let it get you bitter, because, I mean, as much as this hurts what I'm going through right now, it would hurt me so much more to know that it could turn me bitter and that I did allow it to, because, you know, God doesn't deserve bitterness from me. You know, He's been so good to me, and He's brought me through so many things before this even happened. And He gave me the strength the whole month that Robert was in the hospital to go back and forth every day. You know, He gave me the right job before all this happened so that I would be able to go back and forth and see Him every day and spend that time, that precious, precious time with Him that I didn't know at the time was my last time to spend with Him. You know, so I can look back and be so thankful despite the heartache, despite the tears, and the sadness. I can be thankful that God still allowed me to be His wife and allowed me to get to know Him and to love Him and Him to love me and us to have such a good life together. So I'm thankful for that, and I'm thankful for the friends and the family that I have that knew Him as well as me. And with the, you know, that way we can keep His memory alive, because I don't want to forget Him. I mean, it hurts to think about Him, but my goodness, I don't want to forget Him, because He was one of the best parts of my life, you know. So why would I want to forget that? But I just wanted y'all to know I'm okay, even though I'm crying right now. Oh, my goodness. But I'm okay, and I did fine, and I slept good last night, and I had a good day at work. It's really helping me to get back to work with my friends and the babies and the kids and just be able to see, you know, everybody and just to feel a part of something and to know that that God has such a plan for my life. And so y'all just keep praying for me, praying for our family, because this is still a struggle. We still miss Him so much. And everywhere I look, I see Him, you know. So just continue to pray about all that. As far as me and Dallas finding a place, I do have one place I'm going to check out in the next few days, hopefully, and I'm going to pray about it. I had another place I had checked out a few days ago, but I just didn't feel like it was the right fit for us. So y'all just keep praying, because I want to be where God wants me to be in every area of my life, not just where I live. So I'm going to go, and I'm going to change clothes, get in my comfy clothes, and play with my dog for a while. He's standing right here beside me. Say hey. Say hey, everybody. Where's he at? Dallas, can you say hey? Oh, you want me to love on you? But anyway, okay, I'll love on you. But I just appreciate y'all and your care, your concern, your love, your compassion, the hugs that I get when I see y'all, the words of encouragement. Just it just means so much to me, and I cannot thank y'all enough. And I'm now getting attacked by my dog, so I better go so I can play with him. It's like, oh, getting attacked by Freddy Krueger when I come home from work. Dallas, chill. Take a chill pill. He's so cute, but he's so rotten. But anyway, y'all have a good night, okay? And enjoy relaxing for a while if you're able to relax. And be sweet and be kind and be safe. And I'll talk to y'all tomorrow. I'm still believing in what I know and not what I see or hear. Hashtag Waldo Warriors. Hashtag Baby Steps. I love y'all dearly. Good night. Or good afternoon. I keep saying it's nighttime. Good afternoon. It will be, I'll tell you this. Good evening. Good evening. So anyway, I'll let y'all go, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.